Good morning and welcome to Live in a Greenhouse on YouTube. If you're new here, this channel is about my journey to design, build, and then live in the first greenhouse enclosed tiny home in the United States. Being the last weekend of the month, today is the July walk around. We had cooler days than most of the United States, with only one day above 90, and most evenings were in the 50s to low 60s. Temperatures inside the greenhouse peaked just above 90 only twice during the month. By contrast, my brother and his wife live in the desert southwest United States, where most of the month was above 100 and many days above 110 degrees. If I'm diligent about opening the doors and windows overnight to cool off the house and then closing the windows again before the hottest part of the day, inside the house stays relatively comfortable, about the mid-upper 70s. There's no rain in the forecast, but we did get a few drops on the 21st that didn't even cover the ground. Last month, I stopped filling the pool so that I could reserve at least 1,000 gallons in the rainwater tanks to try and make it through until the next rain. But the rainwater tanks ran dry about mid-month, and I'm now drawing out of the pool to irrigate inside the greenhouse, and I don't water outside at all. This is my second year gardening inside the greenhouse, although last year I got the bed set up so late, I really considered it just an experimental year. This year I did get an earlier start on the planting, but I do still consider it an experimental year as I'm learning what can grow where due to the light patterns, and also how and how much and when to water. I estimate there was about 2,700 gallons in the pool when the rainwater tanks ran dry, which isn't enough to make it through the rest of the dry season if we don't get at least an inch of rain. So now I'm making the hard choices. What do I want to pull now so I don't waste any water on it? What do I want to wait a little bit longer to see if we do get some rain, but I may ultimately end up having to pull it? And what is the priority to keep watering regardless and possibly even having to use potable water if even the pool runs out of water? So if you enjoyed this content, please like and subscribe so YouTube will show it to more viewers, and come along today as I show you how I'm dealing with running out of water. The wildflowers had been beautiful through June and into July, but are now fading. Although I mow most of the yard, I've left this patch of tall grass for the fawns to bed in, and they do seem to be using it. These awning windows have temperature controlled openers, so they haven't started to open yet this morning. The areas that get some shade are still green and blooming. The areas with full sun are starting to brown up. I still hope to get a fresh coat of paint on the deck later this summer. Finally discouraged the deer from this hydrangea. It's actually more than 5 years old, but this is the first time it has bloomed. Working on the tool shed means starting a new pile to go to the dump. More work on this shed this month. I removed the siding from the north side, also removed the toilet and capped off the waste pipe. There has been a lot of water and rodent damage, so I ran a UV light, and now I'm using a shellac-based primer. Next up is framing in new windows and a steel door. I'm hoping to actually move tools into this building in August. You can start the bedding pool now, folks. These are two 2,500-gallon tanks. This should have been enough given how much it normally rains for 9 to 10 months a year, but they're empty. Fortunately, we plan for the potential to add two more tanks, if needed, that come up from the road behind that other shed. The awning windows seem to have some effect, but not enough to be able to keep the west doors closed, so I'm working with Matt on another idea to bring more air into the greenhouse. The cargo net is still in place to keep the deer out. The southwest corner is in shade now for a few hours. I love these sunflowers here to provide a little shade on the center aisle. The Sam Houston peach is only 2 years old, but over July I got about a dozen peaches. Compared to last year, there were only three. I didn't see the deer, but it must have been small enough to get around the edge of the cargo net and only grazed lower branches. And some lettuce. And was heading toward the flowers when I heard it and it ran away. The lotus plant is still under the tree, where I can top it off with fresh water every couple days until it can go back into the pool. The screen is temporarily stapled over the opening until I can build and paint the screen frame. Not sure whether this drought makes me sadder that I can't fill the pool to swim over the summer, or that I can't tidy up this mess of the gabion basket and rocks until I can test for leaks at the 3-foot water level. When I was living in the trailer while the house was being built, I would set up a temporary clothesline while the workers weren't here. I may have a washer and dryer now, but why waste electricity when I have this space available? Got the first mini white cucumber, and there's at least one slicer coming on. Lots of tomatoes, which I love, so this is a priority to keep watering. I laid soaker hose, which worked great when fed from the standpipe, but the pool pump isn't strong enough to pressurize these hoses. This is the second planting of bok choy that I wanted to see how it would do in this area during the summer, but I'm not sure the experiment is worth the water. The friendly dill and asparagus are doing well. I'm pulling red potato for dinner a couple nights per week. I've given up on the radishes in this area in favor of letting the potatoes take over. But this is my first time growing kohlrabi, so I really want to see it through to maturity. There's some sort of pest that's hurting everything in this perimeter bed. The ladybugs didn't take care of it. It looks like eggs, but I don't know of what. Lemon balm. Lavage. This is the south wall, and the peas did well here during the cooler months, but it's too hot here now. I'll pull these this weekend. Got a huge harvest of purple beans and green provider beans, but I wasn't fond of their taste, so I've pulled those plants and will try different varieties next year. The watermelon is putting on lots of growth and flowers and one little fruit, but has some problem I don't know what it is. I'm going to take pictures and a couple leaves to the local nursery to see if they can advise. Although the lettuce had been growing well, it was bitter, so I pulled it to let the beets come on, and I've been enjoying beets for a couple weeks now. Asparagus is still doing well. Carrots in the middle. And this is the north end of this bed, so even though the yellow cherry tomato is spreading, it's casting shadow only on the sunflowers. Tomato has just about enveloped the Thai basil. And the Genovese basil. More leeks around both sides of this bed, and I started harvesting these bunching onions this week. The olive tree is still putting on new growth, although taken over by the fennel. The calamondin is finally starting to grow taller and not just bushier, but I'm just grateful it even survived the construction and freezing twice. The story this month for the ornamental beds is the Godizia and Portulaca are really coming on. This is the garden I see when working at my day job. So I love all the color now. Although something, I think powdery mildew, is hitting the columbine and nasturtiums pretty hard. I do still see some of the ladybugs throughout the food and ornamental beds. More coneflowers blooming, but I think it's now too hot for the borage. Plus, I don't want it to go to seed, so I may pull it soon to give more sun to the rosemary. This was a surprise. I don't know what it is. It came from a wildflower mix I spread last year. This stuff will move to the tool shed when it's done. I need to stop talking about cleaning up this corner and finally do it to be ready for Matt's return for another project. This is the east side of the house, so I don't think the spearmint is getting too much direct sun, but the ambient temperature is too hot for it, and it's not getting enough water. I'm thinking about taking cuttings to start new plants inside. Nothing happening on the east pond. It's ready for water. In the meantime, the frogs are happy hanging out. Finally decided on the sofa for the sitting area. I selected this one because both sides fold up and down. And there's a pull-out tray. The cushions aren't as cushy as I'd like, so I'll probably modify that over the winter for next spring. And there you have it. This year is a very different July from last year. This year is more plants of all kinds, but less water. Lower temperatures, but still figuring out ways to deal with the heat. Less time relaxing, but more comfortable when doing it. Now to get out the kayak and get onto the water. Thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, and share with your friends, and come back next time to find out, do we get rain or does the drought continue?